Maria, unfortunately broke her foot and couldn't come today. So instead you get me. I'm Catherine Little Hale Oki. I'm the author of Happy Valley. And this is my first time to present about Happy Valley here in Nagoya. So quite excited to tell you about it. All right, well, as you can see, we've got two chubby little characters up here. This is Kinka, and this is Pinka. And I would like us to say hello, because we always sing a hello song when we begin our classes, right? So would everyone just stand up with me? All right, in Happy Valley 1, the hello song is a very simple hello, 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 hello. But for today, I like to kick it up a notch to the second level, and let's just wave our hands and say hi, hello, all right? And I'm going to be giving you instructions while we do this, okay? All right, so let's go for it. Hi, hello. Billy Bus and Betty Bus, and they head out to Chipperton, which is part of Happy Valley. It's sort of the town, main town. So in Happy Valley 2, we find ourselves going to all these different places in Chipperton. And we first introduce the vehicles by which we go. Right? Sometimes we'll take the helicopter, sometimes we'll take the car, sometimes the bus. And each unit begins with a story. So this is our story time. And I think the picture is cut off there a little bit, but you can see in the top it says one story time. Yeah. So I'm going to play just a part of the story so you can listen. And I'll be pointing out some things as we go, okay?
Hello, everyone, and welcome to Chipperton. Kinka and Pinka, can you say hello?
Hello.
Today, Kinka and Pinka are looking at all the vehicles. What do you see?
Brum, it's a bus.
Yes, Pinka, there are two buses.
It's Billy and Betty. Hello, Billy.
Hi, Pinka.
Hello, Betty.
Hi, Kinka. What color are they?
Red.
Brum.
What else do you see?
It's a plane. It's white.
Well done, Kinka.
Whoosh. It's a white plane.
Wow. Very good, Pinka. It is a white plane.
And it's a helicopter.
What color is it, Kinka?
It's a yellow helicopter. Fluck.
Fantastic.
All right, I'm going to stop it there. The first story is a bit longer, actually, than the other stories because we're bringing in some of the review from Happy Valley 1. This is the first unit, so we're bringing in some of the language from Happy Valley 1. But you might have noticed, how did we say hello? It wasn't hello, it was also hi, hello. Because we go from hello in the first level to hi, hello in the second. So that comes in as well in the story. What do you think the main language is?
Vehicles.
Yes, vehicles. Anything else?
Colors.
Colors. So the main language we always introduce in a context through the story on the first two pages. And after that, we then want to isolate the vocabulary. So I'm going to do a chant, and you're going to help me, okay? All right. So for this one, you guys can sit for the first one. But after that, you're going to get up. All right? So let's try it.
Car. Truck.
Truck.
Plane.
Plane.
Boat. Car, truck, plane, boat.
Car, truck, plane, boat.
Tractor.
Train.
Bus.
Helicopter.
Such quick learners. But the students pick it up. They realize, oh, the fourth one, I have to say it too, right? All right, now what I need you to do is I want you to stand up for this one. And we're going to add some gestures, okay? So for the gestures, car. I do like beep, right? Car. How about truck?
Honk,
right? Yeah. And for plane? Yeah, there you go. And a boat? What do you guys think? Oh, okay, boat. I do boat. You can do whatever you want. You can do your own if you want to. That's fine. How about tractor?
Yeah.
I do this. Like it's turning, right? Turning the ground. Tractor. How about train? Yeah, I do the same. Train. Even though the trains don't look like that anymore. How about that one?
Bus. Yeah, bus. Very good.
And helicopter? Okay, a lot of people do this. This is mine. I think, I don't know. But you can do that too. All right, let's try it with the
car. Truck. Plane. Boat.
Car, truck, plane, boat,
tractor.
down yet. Wait. All right. So, as you know, you guys got quite good at it. By the third, fourth lesson, the kids have it. I don't even have to do anything. I just stand there and watch them. So, yeah, they get really good at it. So, on the next one, I need you to get your hips going a little bit. All right. We're going to do a little it's up, it's up, it's up, it's up, it's up. Can you do that with me? Let's try it just one time. Ready? Go.
It's up, it's up, it's up, it's up, it's up.
You got it. Okay. So this time we're going to add the it's a car. It's a car. All right. You got to move your hands. Ready?
It's up, 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 it's up.
And they would just use the puppets to do it. So it gives them a chance to take part without speaking at first, right? So they can relax. But over time, maybe the second, third, and definitely by the fourth lesson, I don't even need the recording. They just do it. So what I'd like to do is if this half of the class could be Kinka, okay? And this half of the class, you guys get to be Kinka, okay? So Kaori, would you mind being Kinka for everybody over here? And Anna, would you mind being?
Sure.
Okay, thank you. All right. So shall we try together saying, yeah? Okay. All right, let's try it. Ready? One, two.
What is it? It's a car. It's red.
It's a red car.
So over time, the kids are saying as a group, and then by the third, fourth lesson, you can choose one or two students to come up and try it. So lucky you two, you get to try it. But I brought some cars so you can choose what color you like. 100 yen shop. They've got lots of cars. I have so many 100 yen shop cars that my daughter now has started to play with. But let's see. Okay, Pinka, which color would you like?
I do like this red.
You want the red one? Okay.
Yes.
And that's okay. It's the same dialogue, but that's all right. She's chosen it, right? So let's try again, okay? All right. But on this one, can you guys point? What is it? All right, let's try it. Ready? One, two.
What is it? It's a car. It's red.
It's a red car.
You got it. All right, and then you can change different colored cars. I've also used Jeeps and Range Rovers and all kinds of things. So kids have their choice. Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you. Yeah, so I really love the using these because the kids little by little start to feel more comfortable. At first, it's not them talking, it's Kinka and Pinka talking, right? Or maybe it's Sissy Snake. It's a little bit of a snide one. But anyway, yes. Okay, so once we have the dialogue, we want to use a little more, go a little deeper with it, get it really stuck in their brains. So for this one, we have a really rockin' song, and I'm gonna need your help with this. So I want everybody to stand up, right? Okay. And we're going to create a conga line. Right? Because I really like to let my students at least one time in the class go around freely. All right? I make sure their socks are off so that nobody slips and hurts themselves. But you know, how often do kids get to run around in the classroom in first grade? Not very often. No running, right? But I think a little bit's all right, you know? So what we're going to do is, because we've got desks and chairs, let's just sort of, we're going to kind of work our way around this way, all right? So work your way out. I'll guide you. I'll lead you. All right. All right, everyone, get your air guitar.
Beep, beep, it's a car, it's red.
Come on!
It's a truck, it's orange.
Go on.
Honk,
They know they have to be back at their sabaton, their cushion, and they have to sing that part. It's a yellow helicopter. So they know that part is theirs to sing, right? And they have to stop and look and look. So, all right. I think we all have the pattern down, right? What is it? It's a red car, etc. So, at this point, I'd like to play a game. Well, in your classrooms, you can probably put things up on the walls and around the classroom. I do that every class. But today, since I can't put things on the wall, I'm going to ask for some volunteers just to hold the cards, if that would be okay. Would you mind? Okay, one here. Do you mind? Okay. Do you mind coming up here? Yeah. I just want to have you guys sort of in a row, just for demonstration. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, darling. All right. And then I need four students to come up here. Thank you. Hello, lovely students. Thank you.
I'm actually nodding my mind.
Okay. All right. So I have the same four cards here. All right. These are the student flashcards. And I put them in these kind of card holder cases that I got at the Hyakuen shop. I love the Hyakuen shop. I'm a frequent shopper. So I put them in here so that I can play lots of, you know, guessing games and concentration, things like that. But for this game, I'm going to put I'll put the cards actually here. So I'm going to have them on the floor. Okay. All right. Then we're going to go around in a circle. Actually, I'll pull this out of it. Go around in a circle. And I'm going to play some music, okay? And on stop, you're going to stop. Look, ready, go, and you're going to grab a card, okay? You can get one card. Now, I'm going to choose a magic word, okay? Sorry, wrong book. This is Happy Valley too. Okay, I'm going to choose a magic word, so I know from there. Okay, I've chosen the magic word. So, are you guys ready? I'm going to go around in a circle and stop, stop, look, ready, and then go, okay? All right, ready? Don't show anybody, all right? All right. But I'm looking. Okay, all right. Are you guys ready? Can you all say, what is it? What is it? It's an airplane. Ah, it's a white plane.
It's a white plane.
I have a song. That's okay. That's a white plane. It's a white plane. But actually, don't show. Okay, it's a white plane, so I'm going to do a different one, actually. It's okay. All right, can you all ask her? Ready? What is it?
What is it?
It's a red car. It's a red car. Can you say louder?
It's a red car. Louder.
It's a red car.
Good girl. What did you hear? It's a red car. Which one is it? Go, go, run. Run to red car. Everybody, go, 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 go.
Here, it's a red car.
All right, let's try this one more time. All right, come back. Okay, all right, cards down. Cards down. Let's try again. Thank you. All right. So that's that. So this is from Happy Valley 1 CD, but I like to bring a lot of the Level 1 songs back into Level 2 because the students know them, so they're familiar. And after we've done lots of games and lots of songs, we like to have an activity, a settle-down activity. So each unit has four activities, A, B, C, and D, and I do each lesson four times, so one each lesson. But I know some teachers, one of our big fans and wonderful users up in Hokkaido, Mary, she likes to do one in class and then give one for homework, so she does different things than I do, but one idea is to do one in each class. And for these ones, they color, so they can make it a green plane, or a purple plane, or a yellow plane. And then they stand up, and they do their kind of hapyo, their little presentation. It's a green plane, or whatever it is, right? And this one, it's, some things are missing. Do you notice what's missing here?
Tractor.
Yeah, tractor, that's right. What things are missing here?
Helicopter.
Yeah, helicopter and plane, right? So we have stickers in the back of the book, and we have them in a nice little envelope so that you can write the student's name, take them out, and keep them, and only give them during class. I think you know why. Yes, I see a lot of understanding nods. Yeah. So we have the envelope there for you. okay, so recently, Cynthia, who was supposed to present today, she has been creating her own worksheets for Happy Valley, and we now offer them for free up on the website, so you can go to our download section, and you can try them out. She mixes things. She brings in the review numbers from Happy Valley 1 mixed in with the vehicles here from Happy Valley 2. She has an explanation of how to use these also on the website, okay? Here she's done shapes and the vehicles. So again, shapes and numbers from Happy Valley 1 and then the vehicles together to create more review opportunities. And I want to talk a little bit about how to bring in review, because it's really important, isn't it, that we do review and that we recycle the vocabulary as often as possible so students can remember it. And one way that I like to do that with Happy Valley 2 is in the second unit, they learn these places, okay? And then throughout Happy Valley 2, they visit each place, the beach, okay? They go to the farm. And one of my favorite parts of this is here at the beach. Unfortunately, Kinka, he's a little clumsy, okay? He often hurts himself, falls down. He's a little forgetful. He was swimming and, Jilly Jellyfish, who's one of our fawny animals, stings him on the leg, sending him in the next unit to the hospital. It's fiction. we have him. Oh, I'm sorry. He gets stung by a bee. I'm sorry. And Pinka gets stung by a jellyfish, and they end up in the hospital. And after a child goes to the hospital, oftentimes children, you know, they were brave. So where do you take them next? Where would you take them, do you think? Maybe to the toy store to say you did a good job, you can pick out a toy. So we tried to keep the story really flowing throughout each book. And in this, lots of review vocabulary brought in from previous units and units from Happy Valley 1 as well. So for this, one of the games that I like to play is I put the places, the clothes shop, the restaurant, the aquarium, around the room, and the students each choose a card, and then the language is, let's go to the beach, okay, or let's go to the toy store, okay, and then everybody goes to the toy store by their vehicle. So if I'm a boat, I say, oh, toy store, I'm going to go by boat, and we just kind of run around the classroom doing our vehicle gestures and going to those places. All right. Cynthia's worksheets incorporated the shapes. And I really like this song. And so I'd like to for us to do it today. And then I'm going to show a fun activity that I do with the students with shapes. So could everybody stand up again? Thank you. All right. So what do you think? Circle. What would your gesture be for circle? All right. Some people here, some people here, some people here, some people here. Fabulous. There's a variety. Do whatever you want to do, okay? How about for heart? Oh, I just said, yeah. I'm going to take, you all know Kim Horn. Do you guys know Kim Horn? She's, yeah, she's the wonderful Kim Horn. She does this one, so I'm going to take this one. Heart, yeah. All right, so circle and heart for me. How about diamond? Diamond, oh, very good. Oh, yes. Yeah. This. Actually, one of my classes, the students started doing together, which was really neat. They taught me. I'm going to do diamond. Okay. And how about,
that's it, right?
Yes. Okay. Oh, and square.
Square's
kind of hard. Kim's, I'm going to do Kim's. Square.
Nice square. Your whole body is a square.
All right. So let's try this. This is an echo, so you guys can echo with me.
Children's card game. Do you have a? Exactly.
Well, I found on Teachers Pay Teachers this wonderful printable. There's all kinds of stuff on there. And I took these cards, cut them up while I was talking to my friend on the phone, and I made Go Fish Game, all right, using these lovely shapes. So, could I get a couple people to play some Go Fish with us? Anybody? I'm thinking, so everyone can see, maybe we'll do around here. So would you four want to be our Go Fish students? Okay, and if you guys want to stand up and come over and watch how we do this, all right. So are you all familiar with Go Fish? Okay, so you know the basic principles, all right. So we're going to deal, I let the students deal the cards, okay, and we count, of course. So I want everyone counting, okay? All right, ready?
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17.
Actually, we'll stop there because everyone has four. Okay, 16, actually. So in Happy Valley 2, they learn up to number 20. So I try and bring in numbers as much as possible, yes. Now, if you have matching shapes, you can put them down as pairs. You have two of the same shape. Good. What do you have here?
It's a triangle.
That's right. It is a triangle. Very good. Right?
Is that a circle?
Yes, it is a circle. Yeah. Stars. Yes, very good. Stars. Ooh, okay. All right. This is really, I really love this because the kids have, sometimes they have to say, what is it? But to be honest, kids are really good at this. They're sort of better than us. And they're really great at picking out shapes. So, let's go ahead and how about we do rock, scissors, paper. Ready, go.
Rock, scissors, paper. One, two, three.
Ooh, all right, you too.
Scissors, paper, one, two, three.
All right, and then clockwise. We're going to just do clockwise. So you will need to maybe add, well, everyone has a name. Not everybody has a name tag. So you, if you see their name, that's fine. If you don't know their name, what's your name?
Okay.
Okay.
I'll ask John.
Okay.
John, do you have a star?
Yes, I do.
Great.
There
you are. Thank you. All right. Ooh, it's a star.
It is a star. Well done. So at this point, he can either go one more time, or I like to pass it to the next person. That's house rules, you say. All right. So the house rule is you pass to the next person, but you can play however you want in your class. So please go ahead and ask anybody.
Do you
have
triangle?
Yes, I do. I believe that.
You say, here you are.
Here you are.
Nice. All right. Now it's me this time.
Okay. I ask you. Okay. John, do you have time?
No, I don't.
So here, in the American way of playing, you say, go fish. Okay. But it's not very useful language. So we say, please take one.
Okay. Please take one.
Oh, I have
pairs.
So
yes, you can
put your
hair
down. I have circles.
Oh, very good. Yes. Congratulations. Okay, now it's John's turn.
Okay, ready. Do you have a triangle?
Please take one.
Did you get a triangle?
I did not.
You did not, so you do not have a triangle. Okay, that's right. And it passes then to Scott.
Sorry, what's your name?
Mila.
Mila, do you have a diamond?
Yeah.
Sorry.
Eeyore.
Thank you.
All right, and now he's out. But at this point, I don't want him to be really out, so he can take three cards from the middle. Or you could say two cards, whatever you want. One card is fine too. And play continues just like that. Yeah? Okay? Yeah. Thank you all very much. We'll stop there.
Thank you.
So these are
plastic
card cases from 100 Yen Shop. Yeah, you can also order them from Amazon, and you can get a big pack of like 100 or something like that, or maybe more. Yes. And they're called Toreiningu Card. Card. It's been a while since I've ordered them because I bought a lot of them. So I haven't ordered them well, but yeah, Amazon was great for that. So you can get them.
Card sleeves.
Yes, card sleeves.
You can get them from baseball collectors.
Yes. Yeah, that's right. They're for like the Pokemon cards. Princess. Yes. All right. Okay. We'll just have to start making them. And you know, with the shapes too, I think shapes are great for guessing games. I actually had a teacher say to me once, "Why do you teach shapes?" And I was like, "Geometry? Nature? I mean, shapes are everywhere. They're everywhere. And when students can say shapes, they can then give hints about things, right? So if we're talking about, just going back to this one, it's a diamond. It's a diamond. Which one? It's a triangle. A shell, yeah. It's a long square, a rectangle. It's a rectangle. Okay, a long square.
I teach English good.
Please buy my book. All right. Also, in the back of the books, we have extra songs that appear on the CD but aren't in the actual units. So the How Are You song, or this is the light color song, so blue and white make light blue, etc. And our in, on, under, in, on, under, bye, 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 bye. So we offer these in the back with teaching ideas, of course. And, good, we have time. Do we have time? Okay. This is Tony. Tony is, yes, hi Tony. Tony, my daughter is 1 year and 3 months old, and she loves Tony. And I asked her if I could borrow Tony today, because I want to do a little role play, a very small role play. Do you do role plays in your classes? Yeah? Okay, great. This was the first role play I ever did. This was years ago, before Happy Valley was even a thing. I used a stuffed animal in my classroom because students were always like, you know, three-year-olds kind of tend to, they walk into each other. They step on things, they bump things without even realizing sometimes. So I wanted to teach them, I'm sorry, that's okay. And we have a song, I'm sorry, that's okay, that's okay. I'm sorry, that's okay. Walking by, and you step on him or kind of give him a little kick. Don't hurt him though, okay? All right. All right, so, and lights, camera, action.
Tony! Tony!
Sorry.
That's okay.
Lily will have something to say. All right. So I think role play, simple, really simple. Start very simple, just, I'm sorry, that's okay. All right, here you are, thank you. Whatever it is, really simple. But role play, I think, is a really nice way to get kids using English. And after I did this, the students were running around the classroom on purpose, running into each other. I'm sorry, that's okay. Just having fun with it. So I think role play is a nice way to get that going. And our syllabus shows how much review is between and within the different levels. And our puppets are in the back of every book, so you can cut them out and make them. Picture dictionaries in the back of each book. We have targets, so 12 targets for each book. And when the students get a target, on the bus route, they get 1, 2, 3, 4. Up through 12 for each target. So when they hit the target, they get a sticker for it. And we also do a sticker for attendance. I just give them a sticker for coming to class, basically. Free downloads, teacher's guide in Japanese and in English, lesson plans. We also have training videos. The gestures, beep, beep, honk, honk. A lot of teachers were saying, oh, I can't think of gestures. I was a cheerleader. So I'm really quick to think of gestures, and I talk a lot with my hands, if you haven't noticed. So we give you all the vocabulary, has a gesture, and you can watch them for free on the website. And these are all the materials, our DVD, flashcards, student and teacher stickers, CDs. We also have a DVD that comes with a workbook that Kim Horn actually co-authored with me. These are our fun animals. We have a brand new phonics program. Our DVD has the phonics song like this. We have a nice little
Alliant. Billy Bus.
So each of the characters has a gesture to go with the sound. And here's our new phonics program, which you can see at our table. And let's say goodbye. Alright, everyone, will you stand up with me? Oh yes, I'll talk about that in a second. Bye, goodbye. Goodbye, goodbye. Alright, let's try. Oh no, I'm sorry, we're gonna do Happy Valley One. It's very simple. It's more simple. Goodbye, goodbye, goodbye.
Goodbye, goodbye, goodbye. Goodbye, goodbye, goodbye. Goodbye, goodbye, goodbye. Goodbye, 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 goodbye.
Look at each other.
Goodbye, goodbye, goodbye. Goodbye, goodbye, goodbye. Goodbye, 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 goodbye.
See you. Thank you very much. Also, we have a new app that we're testing now. So if you'd like to sign up, it's free. And you can try it with your students and give us feedback. And you can sign up for that at the table.